but she and my dad were readers, you know, and so they were reading about hippies, and they decided that hippies were a good idea. And so then we started to have some in our lives. And my grandparents lived down in Virginia in a college town, and I remember my grandmother saying that she couldn't get her parking brake down, and there was this hippie passing by, and he had very long hair and sandals, and she said, "Excuse me, young man," he was so friendly, "about putting down the parking brake." And so, you know, we were all starting to have these positive hippie experiences, and so my parents hired a hippie to paint the house, and he left. He said, "Mrs. Williams, there's this canoeing trip in Alaska, my friends are all going, and I just really want to go, can I just do that, and then come back and finish your house?" And she's like, "Yes, yes, you are a free spirit. Go ahead." And so we had this like unpainted house, you know, half painted house, because you know that's what you did, you know. And so we had this other person come into our lives, and she was just so magical. And we all experienced that. And you know, when my parents left us with her for a weekend once, and they went away, you know, they'd never done that. And my sister wanted to make donuts, which you know is fried oil and mess, and my parents were like, "Of course, that's what people do when they're free like that." And so there was oil all over the ceiling, nobody got hurt. And so this person was our babysitter, this wonderful woman, and so I wrote this song for her. It's called "The Babysitter's Here," but I think any member of my family could have written this song. Written this song, just sort of recognizing what came through our lives. Here we go. Tonight was just great. She taught us the sign for peace. Now she's made us some popcorn. We've turned out the lights and watched she movies. Don't understand, and she tries to explain how a spaceship is riding through somebody's brain, and there's blood and guts in. She's the best father we've ever had. She sits on her hair, and she's tall as my dad, and she tie-dyed my shirt, and she pierced her own ear, and it's peace. Man, cool, yeah, the babysitter's here. Her boyfriend is Tom, but we call him the king of romance. He wears an American flag on the butt of his ripped up. Get married with kids of their own. He says, "Not if she's going to college, we won't." And he kisses her. Oh, someday I'll have a boyfriend just like that. She's the best father we've ever had. She sits on her hair, and she's tall as my dad. And she got me to dinner, and Tom drank a beer. But peace, man. Hey, the babysitter's here. And we all went to see her go dance at the high school. We made her pick. Carnage told us that she'd be the unicorn wearing the pink leotard. And there she was sleeping up just like she said, with a sparkling horn coming out of her. And she's whoa. I can't wait to give her the card. I can't wait to give her the card. She's the best one. Okay, so the play was called The Unicorn, and she was the unicorn, so that means that the star was my babysitter. But this Saturday night, I can't sleep, and I'm watching the news. She says, do me a favor, don't go with the guy who would make you choose. And don't understand, and she tries to explain. And all that mascara runs down in her pain, cause she's leaving me. You're the best one that we've ever had. You sit on your hair and you're tall as my dad. And I'll make you a picture for college next year. So hush now. Peace now. The baby.